That's really interesting. And since you mentioned the Mandela effect, I have to ask you a few questions about the Mandela effect. So we have had a bunch of guests on about Mandela effect.
It's a fascinating subject.
It is one of my fast. Okay, so who was the person who was the face of the Publishers Clearinghouse when you were a kid?
Ed McMahon.
Obviously, no. It's Ed McMahon. It's right. Obviously Ed McMahon. Ed McMahon has never been
but
part
who
of
who are they saying it is now?
They've never been associated with Ed McMahon.
What?
Never. Apparently he was part of family circle.
I haven't heard this one.
I've heard the
magic mirror and all that stuff, but I haven't heard this one yet.
Oh, I'm going to blow your mind a little bit here, Mark. This is just going to be fun. Anyone still listening, this is just going to blow your head. So prepare yourselves. Ed McMahon has never been a part of Publishers Clearinghouse. He never was the guy handing checks with big balloons at people's doors.
Oh, I remember. I could almost, if I could draw and I could sketch every moment of it.
Millions of us who remember this. Okay, is it Jif peanut butter or Jiffy peanut butter?
That's another one that got me. Jiffy, for sure.
It's Jif. It's never been
I know,
Jiffy.
I know. I've heard that. But the one that gets me the most is the magic mirror on the wall thing. That is always mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
And what is it?
Oh, it's a magic mirror on the wall. That's what it says now.
That's BS. That's BS. There's no magic.
Oh, I know.
It's mirror on
that's
the wall.
That's right. It's always
it's not
been
magic
mirror
on the wall. That makes no sense. Okay. Field of Dreams. Remember the movie Field of Dreams?
Oh, I haven't heard this one yet.
All right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I know that by heart. I know
with Kevin Costner. Everyone who's listening. 89. Kevin Costner.
I remember Field of Dreams. Actually, the guy who played Darth Vader's voice is in that movie.
Well, James Earl Jones. Yes.
Yes.
What do they say? What is the voice that he hears in the field? If you build it, they will come.
If you build it, they will come.
No.
What does it say now?
Go watch the movie tonight and it will say, if you build it, he will come.
He will come.
But yes, it's they will come.
No, they will come.
It is they will come because it's always been they, of course.
Wait a minute.
Let's go into Star Wars. Wars.
Oh, definitely Empire Strike. Luke, I'm your father.
No, is it Luke, I am your father?
Yeah.
It's
definitely.
Not. It's not.
I know. It's like gone and watched some of these movies. Like there's also one in Forrest Gump.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't know this one.
I have three little second cousins that were in that playing. They were extras in the movie. They were playing jump rope. And when he's talking to
I remember that scene.
The African American lady on the bench, there was a scene where they were. Those are my cousins.
Nice. So what is it in there?
Life is like a box of chocolates. Mama always said, "Life is like a box of chocolates."
But that's the line, isn't it?
That's got to be.
And it isn't. It isn't that.
No,
I don't know.
No, it isn't that.
What is it now?
It says something like, Jfro, what is it now? Life is like a box of chocolates, but the Mandela effect. It's like life is, I don't remember either. I'm going to Google it.
So, all right, last one, because we can go this forever.
But it's not
so many.
It's something totally different, too.
It's life a lot. It's life is like a box of chocolates.
Now, I didn't know about the Wellington Bear thing.
The Berenstain Bears.
I never saw that when I was growing up, so I didn't even get that one. But.
Yeah, Berenstain Bears. All right, I'll give you one more. Fruit of the Loom, okay?
Fruit of the Loom.
Fruit of the Loom.
They had the bowl
cornucopia.
Of fruit.
Yeah, the cornucopia fruit, right?
That was in the middle of the
yeah, and
label.
The fruit came out of the corn. It's called the cornucopia. Right. I think that little kind of horn, that little horn thing that the fruit came out of. Right? No, never existed.
What?
It's just been fruit. So this is the Mandela effect. If you haven't, if everyone listening, you have not heard of the Mandela effect, Google it. Have some fun. I have episodes with quantum physicists talking to me about the Mandela effect. That are out on the channel as well, so you can take a look at that.
Now here's another perspective I was thinking about. Did you ever see that show Lost?
Of course, yeah.
Okay, Hurley in the game.
Yeah.
Sometimes I think we're actually, those of us living right now, actually that happened to, like we all really died, like in 2012. I think when the Mayan calendar ended, we switched dimensions. And that's when all this, if you remember, that's when all this Mandela effect stuff started, was right around that time.
Like so I said, maybe we're all dead. All I gotta say is let's hope and pray there's no smoke monster here. Anyway, my friend, I'm gonna ask
smoke monster.
I don't.
Wasn't it started with a J? Not Jericho. No,
all I know is the writers got really lazy at the end of that show. That's all I'm saying. They got really disappointed
with the very end.
Of course, it was a horrible ending. But anyway, I'm going to ask you a few questions. Ask all my guests, Mark. What is your definition of living a fulfilled life?
Living a fulfilled life. Whew. Well, that's a really great question, because we all seem to have little different takes on that. Mm-hmm. Living a fulfilled life. I haven't lived it yet. Even though I've had a full life, I mean, I've experienced things that most people will never experience in their lifetimes. But I would say just, now let me ask you this. Do you mean like the possibilities?
Yes. Because... Well, yeah. How do you define living a fulfilled life or a good life? It's a general statement.
Yeah. Get rid of fear in your life. Mm-hmm. Number one. Fear is the opposite of love in my book. And fear, if once you get rid of fear, you're going to feel the freest you've ever felt ever in your life. And now, those of us who have had these NDEs and are astral projected, we can tell you firsthand that we don't die. So that's one fear you can erase from your book. So once you understand that we don't die, then you understand, like, if you jump off a cliff or you're in a bad car wreck or whatever, I can assure you that even before that car wreck happens, or you fall off that cliff or whatever, your soul is going to come out of your body before any of that happens. And this is just,
I've heard this is how it's
going to be. So once you get rid of all the fear, then you can live a more fulfilled life, because then you're not afraid to experience new things and do things. And I mean, of course, that doesn't mean we go out and rob banks. There's negative consequences that come with those kind of negative decisions. But,
gotcha.
But yeah, once you realize fear is stopping you from doing so many things, then you can live more of a fulfilled life.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.